गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। गुड
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
ओके, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून। सो लास्ट क्लास वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड मॉड्यूल 5। सो मॉड्यूल 5 सम ऑफ द टॉपिक वी ऑलरेडी कवर्ड। सो टुडेज क्लास विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन ऑफ मॉड्यूल 5। ओके, सो so this PPT is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, yes, so last class we already discussed about the different types of sheet metal cutting, sheet metal operation. Okay, sheet metal operation we already discussed. So what are those? Chetan. Chetan.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me different types of sheet metal operation? Sheet metal operation. So that topic we already discussed in the last class, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, blank. Don't know. So major three different types of sheet metal operations. One is cutting operation. Second one is bending operation. Third one is which one? Drawing operation. These are the three operation. Okay, cutting operation, bending operation, as well as drawing operation. So cutting operation is nothing but cut the workpiece from the big sheet. Okay, in a big sheet, cut some portion. That is nothing but cutting operation. Bending is nothing but applying pressure with the help of punch or ram. So because of that pressure, so that sheet metal will be bent to a some extent. Okay, around 90 degree, 70 degree, based on the requirement. Okay, that is called as bending operation. Next one is drawing operation. Based on the punching pressure, we can draw that sheet metal. So you can convert that sheet metal into different shape, like container, cup, different shape we can produce. That is called as drawing operation. So tension as well as compression, both type of stresses is included during drawing operation, drawing of sheet metal. Understood? So this operation, so cutting, bending and drawing, are these are the three major operation of sheet metal. Okay, so this operation we already seen. Okay, this is called as sheet metal cutting operation. So sheet metal cutting operation, this operation we already studied. So can you tell me the different sheet metal cutting operation? Anyone?
Blanking, piercing, punching, lancing, parting and notching.
Okay, good. Okay, these are the different sheet metal cutting operation. Sheet metal cutting operation. First one is blanking operation. So blanking is nothing but remove the metal. So initially workpiece is placed above the die, and with the help of punch we can remove certain part of the workpiece. So that removed part is called as useful workpiece. Okay, removed part is called as useful workpiece. That operation is called as blanking operation. So these are the three varieties of operation. One is cutting operation, bending operation and drawing operation. So cutting, you can remove certain part. Bending is nothing but convert that sheet metal into desired shape. And drawing operation is nothing but draw into a sheet, draw the sheet, and you can convert that into sheet into required shape, like cup, container shape. Okay, that is called as drawing operation. Next one is piercing operation. So what is that piercing operation? So piercing operation is nothing but first mark the dimension in the sheet, actual sheet, and remove the unwanted part. That then you will get the required product. Then you will get the required product, finished product. Here removed part is act as a scrap. What is the main difference between blanking as well as piercing? So blanking is nothing but removed part is called as useful part. Here in piercing, removed part is called as scrap and remaining part is called as useful part. Okay, that is the main difference between blanking as well as piercing operation. Understood? Blanking is nothing but removed part is called as useful part. In piercing operation, So removed part is called as scrap, and remaining part is called as useful part. Next one is punching operation. So punching is nothing but, so same as blanking and piercing operation. So the sheet metal is placed above the die and apply pressure with the help of punch. You can remove the certain portion. The disadvantages is with the help of punching operation, you can create hole in the sheet metal, but other than hole is not possible in punching operation. So other than hole, so semicircle or full circle hole you can create with the help of punching operation. Other than hole operation is not possible in with the help of punching operation. Okay, next one is lancing operation. So what is lancing? Lancing is nothing but
combination of piercing and punching.
Yes,
a partial cut in sheet so that a material is removed.
Yes. So it is a combination of piercing as well as punching operation. So once the metal is not cutting here. So once the material is separated from the sheet metal, that extra part, scrap part, you can bend to a certain extent. Okay. So here you can see the cutted portion is bent to a certain angle, 90 degree angle. Operation is called as lancing operation. So this is mainly used for decoration purpose. Okay. Decorative item. We can use this lancing operation. Okay. So remove the metal, and that extra part of metal is not separate from the sheet metal. Instead of that separation, just rotate to a some extent. Okay, rotate to an some angle. Okay, 90 degree angle, bent to an angle. So that operation is called as lancing operation. Next one is parting off. So parting off is very simple. Okay, parting off is nothing but, so extra part of sheet metal you can remove with the help of punch. Okay, so the extra part of sheet metal is placed outside from the die. Okay, extra part of sheet metal is placed outside from the die, and sheet metal will be held with the help of stripper. So I will tell you what is stripper and different types of stripper. Everything is there in your syllabus. I will explain later. Okay, stripper. So the purpose of using stripper is to hold the workpiece properly. Hold the workpiece properly. That is a function of stripper. Okay, the extra part of sheet metal is placed outside in the die, and this force you should apply with the help of punch. With the help of that punching force, that extra part of sheet metal will be separate. Okay, extra part of sheet metal will be separate. That operation is called as parting off operation. Understood? That operation is called as parting off operation. Next one is notching. So notching, I already explained that notching operation, everything is there. Notching in your syllabus is there in FM lab. So notching is nothing but remove the edge part of the sheet metal. Remove the edge part of small portion you can remove. Okay, with the help of this notching operation. Okay, so edge part you can remove, and you will get the small portion. So within that, the water is flowing. That that experiment is there in FM lab. So during that time, I will clearly explain what is notching everything. Okay, so here actual notching operation is nothing but removing the edge part of the sheet metal. That is called as notching operation. Understood, right? Understood, right? So notching is nothing but removing the edge part of the sheet metal. That is called as notching operation. So these are the different sheet metal cutting operation. Now we'll see the sheet metal bending operation. Okay, so sheet metal cutting operation we already studied. So now we'll see the sheet metal bending operation. Different bending operation is also there. Okay, so these are the different types of bending dies. Okay, bending operations. Bending die is nothing but bending operation, both are same. Okay, so for particular shape, if you want to get, you should use the particular shape of die itself, so that it is name given as bending dies. Okay, bending dies. So how much we studied in the last class? Anyone?
Bending.
Huh?
Edge bending, sir.
Edge bending.
Edge bending. Okay. So wiping die as well as edge bending, both are same. Okay. Wiping die as well as edge bending, both are same. So same, it is nothing but 90 degree edge rotate to a 90 degree. Okay, that is called as wiping die. It is also called as edge bending. Sometime in the exam they will ask wiping, explain with a neat sketch wiping die. Sometime they will ask with a sketch, explain edge bending operation. Okay, so both are same, wiping die as well as edge bending operation. Okay, we'll see one by one. Okay, so this is the sketch of wiping die. Okay, wiping die sketch, very simple. Lower shoe, upper shoe. So upper shoe is also called as ram. Okay, and flanges, flanges is nothing but punch. Okay, flanges is nothing but punch, and the die is used. Okay, so above the die sheet metal is placed. Okay, and this is called as pad, is nothing but pressure pad. Okay, so the function of pressure pad is to hold the sheet metal properly, hold the sheet metal properly, otherwise with the during the operation, so bending operation, sometimes sheet metal also moves forward. So that's why we should hold the sheet metal properly. That's why we are using this pressure pad. And this is spring force. It is backward force is applied to the upper shoe. Okay, spring will be acting backward force to the upper shoe. Okay, so this is a working principle. So here initially the sheet is placed above the die, and pressure pad will be fixed to the sheet metal so that it will hold the workpiece properly. Then extra portion will be placed outside from the die, and this upper shoe applying pressure to the upper shoe, and that pressure is moves to the flanges. So flange will be moving downward direction. So during that time it will apply pressure to the sheet metal, that extra portion whatever outside from the die, that will be moving downward. You will get the required shape of edge die. Okay, edge bending. Okay, so it is like edge of the sheet metal will be bent to a certain angle, that is called as edge bending or wiping die. Okay, so edge bending or wiping die. So here this is called as width of the sheet metal will be bent here. Okay, so this is called as edge of the width of the edge. Okay, so this will be bent with the help of this flange pressure. Okay, flange force, this edge of the width of the edge will be bent to a certain angle. Okay, so this is called as wiping die. Next one is V-shaped die. So V-shaped die is nothing but you can produce the different shape in the sheet metal. Suppose if you want to produce the particular shape, you need to collect the same shape of die as well as same shape of punch. Okay, then only you can produce the particular shape of sheet metal. Okay, suppose if you want to produce a V-shape sheet metal, then V shape of die is required, and same shape of punch is required. Same shape of punch is required. Then only you can produce the V shape in the sheet metal. So it is name given as V shape die. Okay, V shape die. Initially, that sheet metal is placed in the die. Okay, initially sheet metal is placed in the die, and the mark, the dimension in the sheet metal, and the proper position also you should set. The die as well as punch should be in same position. Then applying a pressure with the help of punch, you will get the required shape. So the advantages is with the less force you can produce the required shape. The disadvantages is if you want to produce a particular shape in the sheet metal, same size and dimension of die as well as punch is required. That is the disadvantages of V-shaped die. Okay, so same shape. Suppose if you want to produce the 30 degree angled V-shaped die, V-shape in the sheet metal, same dimension of die as well as punch is required. That is the disadvantages of this V-shaped die. Understood? Okay, so next one is U die. So suppose if you want to produce the U shape in the sheet metal, so both die as well as punch you should select in a U shape. Okay, so that is called as U die. Then only you can produce the U shape die, U shape in the sheet metal. Okay, so the procedure is similar. Sheet metal is placed in above the die, and punch is punch as well as die you should set the dimension, then applying downward force with the help of punch, then that metal will be deformed. You will get the U shape of sheet metal. Okay, that is called as U die bending. It is also called as U die bending. Next, edge bending. So I already explained. So wiping die or edge bending, both are same. So here, so pressure pad is using. So initially workpiece is placed above the die and pressure pad is using. The what purpose we are using pressure pad? So hold the workpiece properly, okay, in the die, then applying downward force with the help of punch, then required shape of sheet metal you will get. That is called as edge bending. Edge of the sheet metal will be bent to a certain angle. That is called as edge bending operation. Okay, next one is angle bending operation. So angle bending, so all bending operation is similar. Okay, is nothing but if you want to produce a certain angle or certain shape, so both punch as well as die should be in same dimension. Both punch as well as die should be in selecting a same dimension. That is the disadvantage of sheet metal bending operation. So angle bending, suppose, so if you want to produce this shape in the sheet metal, same shape of die as well as punch is required. Same shape of die as well as punch is required. Okay, then that sheet metal is placed in the die. Okay, sheet metal is placed in a die. Certain pin as well as the holding device is used for proper holding of sheet metal in above the die. Okay, so certain pin, sheet metal pin is available. So I will explain that sheet metal pin everything later. Okay, so that is for proper holding in the above the die. Okay, once it is set in the die, then applying downward force with the help of punch, then you will get the required shape in the sheet metal. That is called as angle bending. Here also, along with pin, we can use the stripper. Okay, the stripper function is to hold the workpiece properly in the die. Okay, hold the workpiece properly in a die. And one more example and advantages of stripper is it will avoid damages to the punch during backward motion of punch. Okay, avoid damages to the punch during backward motion of the punch. Okay, so that is the advantages of stripper. Okay, so one is stripper function is to hold the workpiece properly, and second function is to what? Avoid damages to the punch part. Okay, that is the advantages of stripper. This is an angle bending operation. Next one is curling operation. So curling operation. So curling operation is nothing but the edge of the sheet metal will be rotated to a in circular shape. Okay, edge of the sheet metal will be rotated to a circular shape. That is called as curling operation. So here you can see here the edge of the sheet metal. This is edge of the sheet metal will be rotated to a circular shape. So it is called as curling operation. So how to produce this curling operation? So same thing. So round shape of die as well as punch is required. So the diameter also you should note down. So particular diameter you can produce with the help of die as well as punch in the sheet metal. So initially sheet metal is placed in the die. Okay, so proper holding device is also required for curling operation. Then applying downward force with the help of punch, then this will extend. Okay, this edge of the sheet metal will be extend, and the edge of the sheet metal will be rotate to a circular shape. Okay, edge of the sheet metal will be rotated to a circular shape. This operation is called as curling operation. The edge of the sheet metal will be rotated to a circular shape. Okay, so why we are rotating the edge of the sheet metal? Why? Because that is very dangerous. Okay, so during that time or some other application, during some working application also there. So during that time we can rotate, or you can use this curling operation. Curling operation is nothing but rotating the edge of the sheet metal. Okay, so for this operation you need same circular shape of punch as well as circular shape of die is required. Circular shape of punch as well as circular shape of die is required for this curling operation. Understood? Any doubt in curling operation?
No, sir.
Okay. Next, the last bending operation is forming operation. Okay, last bending operation is forming operation. So form in this two type is there, forming operation. Forming is nothing but deformation of the material. So this is a process in which the workpiece is bent to in some curved axis. Okay, curve shape you can obtain with the help of this forming operation. Forming is nothing but bending operation. Okay, so it's nothing but deformation of the material. So how metal will be deformed? With the help of certain load. With the help of certain load, that sheet metal will be bent or deformation take place. So this is name given as forming operation. So forming operation is further classified into two types. What are those? Forming using die and punch and stretch forming. Okay, forming using die and punch as well as stretch forming. Okay, so I will explain each one. So this is the forming using die and punch. Forming using die and punch. Okay. So here spelling mistake is there. Forming die. Okay, forming die. So this is forming punch. This is upper up, top one is forming punch and bottom one is forming die. And workpiece. Workpiece is nothing but sheet metal is placed above the die. Okay, placed above the die. So forming die is in U shape and forming punch is also in same shape. Okay, forming punch as well as forming die, both are in same shape. So this forming operation is mainly used to produce the curve shape. Okay, in the workpiece. Okay, curve shape, curve axis or curve shape in the workpiece. Okay, so U shape. Workpiece you can produce in forming operation, not you exactly. So it is nothing but curvature. Curvature is produced, okay, in the workpiece. So here same shape of die as well as same shape of punch is required. Initially the workpiece is placed above the die and certain suitable proper holding device is required, like stripper. Okay, then certain pin also attached to the sheet metal, then applying downward force with the help of forming punch. So because of that downward force, that sheet metal will be deformed. Okay, sheet metal will be deformed. Required curve axis you will get in the sheet metal. Okay, required curve axis you will get in the sheet metal, like this structure you will get at the end. Okay, the procedure, everything is same, very simple. You can explain in your own words in the exam also. Okay, so initially workpiece is placed above the sheet forming die, then applying downward force with the help of punch, you will get the required shape. Okay, so this is called as forming operation. So forming using die as well as punch. Second one is stretch forming. So here opposing force is acting. So either side of the sheet metal is connected to the carriage. Okay, two carriage is using and one forming die block is using. Forming die blocks and two carriages are using here. So edge of the sheet metal is fixed to the carriage. So carriage as well as this is die block is stationary. Die block is stationary and carriage will be moving in opposite direction. Okay, it is moving downward direction. So die block is remains stationary. Because of this carriage movement, stretch in the sheet metal will happen and curvature of the sheet metal also obtained. During this operation. Understood, right? Two carriages are using and die blocks is also using. Die blocks is remain stationary. Edge sides of the edge of the sheet metal is fixed to the either side of the carriages. Carriages is moving in opposite direction, downward direction. At the same time, stretch in the sheet metal will happen with the help of this die block. So curvature structure will be obtained in the sheet metal. Curvature axis will be obtained in the sheet metal along with stretch in the sheet metal also happens. So this operation is called as stretching forming, stretch forming. Understood? Stretch forming. So these are the different types of bending operation. Okay, these are the different types of sheet metal bending operation. So now can you tell me, so what are the different bending operation we studied till now?
Wiping die, V-shape die.
Wiping die, V-shape, U-shape, forming. Heads bending.
Okay.
Rolling die and punch and switch forming.
Okay, okay. So please all of you interact. Okay, I will note down in the name those who are interacting with me right now. Okay, please all of you interact. I will give marks based on that also, and along continuous evaluation marks, and based on your this one interaction. Okay, based on your interaction I will give the continuous evaluation marks also. Okay, and also some give some weightage in the internal also. Okay, based on your interaction. Okay, so if you concentrate here itself, then no need of studying in the home. Why? Because it is very simple subject and you can easily score also. Okay, so till now we already studied about what is sheet metal and sheet metal cutting operation, sheet metal bending operation, and third type is sheet metal drawing operation. That also we'll see. So sheet metal drawing operation, this is the drawing operation. Drawing is nothing but producing the cup shape in the sheet metal, producing cup shape in the sheet metal. Okay, so this is nothing but, so initially you just see the parts. Initially this is called as die. Okay, die and guide plate, and this is the draw die radius, draw right radius. The radius is provided in the die on both the sides, and this is air vent. Okay, then punch radius, this is punch radius both sides, and this is punch, and this is blank. Okay, so blanking operation is using here. Okay, blanking operation. So blanking is nothing but what? Initially big size of sheet metal is placed in the die, then removing certain portion. So once it is removed, and then we can use that removed part for useful work. So that is called as blank. Okay, blank. So here removing the certain portion, then that removed portion we can draw into a certain shape, then you will get the required shape of sheet metal, required shape of sheet metal. Initially certain portion of the sheet metal will be removed, that is called as blanking operation. So it is name given as blank. Okay, it is name given as blank. Once the remove the workpiece from the sheet metal, then that workpiece is used and drawing operation, take the drawing operation. So the drawing is nothing but further applying load with the help of punch, and you will get the required shape of cut cup or container or big size you can obtain. Okay, this shape you can obtain. So this is called as sheet metal drawing operation, sheet metal drawing operation. So the basic method understood, right? So next we'll see the drawing operation. Okay, drawing operation. So how drawing operation will carried out? Okay, so drawing operation. So initially blanking operation is used for drawing operation. Once the remove the workpiece, once we are removed the certain portion of workpiece in the sheet metal, then that workpiece is used for drawing operation. Okay, so here initial die is using, and blank holder. Okay, this is blank holder. So blank holder purpose is to hold the sheet metal properly. It is act as pressure pad. Okay, it is act as pressure pad, and this is knockout. This is die, blank holder, punch and knockout. So knockout is just giving support to the sheet metal initially. So just giving support to the sheet metal, and the blank holder will hold the sheet metal properly before starting the operation. Here you can observe it will hold the workpiece properly, then applying force with the help of punch. So because of that force, metal will be deformation take place. At the same time, this knockout also moving downward direction. So with the help of this punching force, sheet metal will be deformed, along with knockout is also moving downward direction. Then once the process is finished, this entire thing, this entire blank holder along with this punch will be moving upward direction. At the same time, this knockout is also moving upward direction. Then you will get the required shape is nothing but cup shape you will obtain. That is called as drawing operation. That is so called as drawing operation. Understood? Initially, knockout is just giving support to the workpiece, and then this is blank holder and punch, and this is die, and both blank holder and punch will be moving downward based on the pressure. So then this blank holder will hold the workpiece properly. Then because of this punch pressure, this sheet metal will be moving downward direction along with this knockout is also moving downward direction. Once the process will be finished, all this blank holder as well as punch will be moving upward direction. Then at the same time, this knockout is also moving upward direction. You will get the required shape of workpiece. Here deformation, actual deformation is take place. Workpiece deformation take place in C process. Okay, desired shape you will obtain. Okay, so this is called as drawing operation. This is called as drawing operation. So all are continuous process. This continuous process will be work based on pneumatic system. Okay, pneumatic or hydraulic system. So any doubt? Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Understood, right? So yes, important portion. Okay, important concept. Sheet metal drawing operation. Okay, sheet metal drawing operation is nothing but you should draw this sketch. Okay, so you should draw this sketch and explain. Okay, you should draw this sketch and explanation. So you can observe here. So how initially blank will be produced. Once the blank will be produced, then how we can draw the drawing to a shape. So initially certain portion will be removed in the sheet metal, that is called as blanking operation. Once the blank will be produced, then that blank workpiece is used and for further process. Okay, further process. You can see here initially certain portion will be removed in the sheet metal, that is called as blanking operation. Once the removed the workpiece, then same workpiece is used for drawing operation. So like this. Okay, so this is cut portion. Actually half portion is shown in the figure. So next one is, so three different parts we already seen. Next, the concept is, this is the different concept, embossing as well as coining operation. Embossing as well as coining operation. This is different operation in the sheet metal. Okay, different operation in the sheet metal. Okay, so once you finish, we already finished the cutting operation, bending operation, as well as drawing operation. These are the three different sheet metal operation. So we already studied. Next we'll study about embossing as well as coining operation. What is embossing and what is coining operation? Okay, so embossing as well as coining, embossing is mainly used for decoration purpose. Okay, decorate, it is act as decorative item. We can produce certain design in the sheet metal. There is no cutting operation, bending operation, nothing. Okay, so producing impression. Okay, producing desired shape of impression in the sheet metal. So one purpose is a decorative, it act as a decorative item, and second one is improve the strength of the sheet metal. That purpose we are using this embossing operation. We can carry out this embossing operation in the sheet metal. So what purpose? One is giving decoration to the sheet metal. Second one is improve the strength of the sheet metal. That purpose we are using this embossing operation in the sheet metal. Okay, so initially the certain shape of suppose if you want to produce a V shape or certain shape in the sheet metal, same shape of die as well as punch is required, same as previous operation, like V die bending operation. Okay, same as bending operation, here also same shape of die as well as punching is required. So then and the process is similar. So the sheet metal is placed in the die, then proper holding device is required. Stripper is used here to hold the workpiece properly. Then certain pins also attached with the die and the sheet metal, then applying downward force with the help of punch. So then you will get the required impression in the sheet metal, required impression in the sheet metal. So you can observe the usually the different types of sheet metal is available in the market. So it is different impression is also given to the sheet metal. The purpose of giving impression is to improve the strength of the sheet metal along with some decoration purpose. Okay, giving this embossing operation, carried out embossing operation. This operation is called as embossing. Understood? Any doubt? Embossing? Any doubt? Tell me, anyone?
No.
Understood? Embossing is nothing but it is mainly used for decoration purpose along with improve the strength of the sheet.
Sir, of any design, sir.
Any design you can produce. But the disadvantage is same dimension of die as well as punch is required. Okay, so that is the disadvantages. Okay, so mass production, usually they will use for mass production. So like certain die and punch is used for some numbers, okay, number of sheet metal. Otherwise, if you want to produce one sheet metal, one die, it is very difficult. It's nothing but cost consumption is very high. So mass production system, this embossing operation is using, okay. So next one is coining operation. Okay, coining operation. So here you can observe the coining operation. So in the market, 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin, 50 paisa coins is available, right? That will be produced with the help of this coining operation. Okay, so this is also one of the process. Okay, coining operation. So both side of the coins having certain impression. So it is nothing but certain impression is producing on the coin. So here in embossing operation, so we are using whole sheet, whole volume of the sheet metal we can deform. Whole volume of the sheet metal will be deformed. But in the coining operation, certain portion we are using, certain portion we are giving impression to the sheet metal. Okay, so that is coining operation. Here also same shape impression, the same impression of die as well as punch is required. Okay, so upper punch is different and lower die is also different. Is nothing but different impression is giving on the either side of the coins. Okay, that purpose. So some designed, some impressioned die is using here and some other impression of holder is also using here. Okay, then the coin is nothing but blank workpiece. So once the certain portion is removed in the sheet metal, that portion is placed in the workpiece, that portion is placed in above the die, then applying impression. How to apply impression? So upper die will be moving downward force, applying downward force, then at that time certain impression will be giving to the sheet metal. Then you will get the required coined part. Okay, you will get the required coining part. So this is called as coining operation. This is called as coining operation. Understood? Understood?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So coining is nothing but, so the parts, which are the parts is required for coining operation? Lower die, workpiece. This is workpiece and die holder and upper die. Okay, upper die. So upper die as well as the lower die should be having some impression. Okay, it may be different impression. Why? Because it should provide either side of the different impression in either side of the coin. Okay, so both lower die as well as upper die is having different impression. Okay, different impression. Then initially certain portion will be removed in the workpiece. That workpiece removed portion is placed above the die. Okay, die is providing, die holder will provide the holding purpose. It is mainly used for holding purpose, holding the sheet metal properly, holding the workpiece properly. Then that sheet metal is placed above the die, then lower die is moving upward direction, upper die is moving downward direction, applying impression to the workpiece, then you will get the required particular impression in the workpiece. The finished part you will get at the end. So this is the finished part. Okay, so you will get a different impression on either side of the workpiece. That is called as coining operation. That is called as coining operation. So I hope all of you understood. So in embossing, we are using whole structure of the sheet metal. It is nothing but whole volume we are using. But in coining operation, we are using certain portion. Okay, we are using certain portion. In certain portion, we are giving impression to the workpiece. Okay, that is the main difference between embossing as well as coining operation. So next one is trimming operation. Trimming is nothing but removing the workpiece. Extra part we can remove. Okay, that is similar to that of parting operation. Okay, trimming operation is similar to that of parting operation. Extra part of sheet metal we can remove. Okay, so this is the die pad. Die pad is nothing but pressure pad. So pressure pad will hold the workpiece properly in the above the die. This trimmed sheet, we can remove the sheet with the help of this trimming tool. Okay, trimming tool will be moving downward and extra part of sheet metal will be removed, take place. Okay, this is called as trimming operation. Next one is shearing operation. Shearing is nothing but shearing process. So different types of stress we already discussed, tensile, compressive and shear. Shearing is nothing but two metal will contact, take place. Rubbing action take place, that is called as shear force. So here sheet metal is moving in opposite, not sheet metal. So both punch as well as die are in, punch is moving opposite direction of the die. Okay, opposite direction of the die. Then shearing force take place. Because of that shearing force, metal will be deformation take place, or metal will be cut take place. Metal will be cut take place. That is called as, that process is called as shearing process. That process is called as shearing process. Initially, the edge of the workpiece will be deformation take place, crack take place. Initially, because of this punch pressure, edge of the sheet metal deformation take place. So edges, either side of the edge of the sheet metal will be deformation take place, crack formation take place. Once the crack formation, further if you further downward movement of this punch, full cut, extra part of sheet metal will be cut take place. So that is called as shearing process. That process is called as shearing operation. Okay, that process is called as shearing process or shearing operation. So this trimming as well as shearing process I will explain in the next class once again. Okay, so today's class, what are the portion we discuss? Anyone?
Types of bending die, drawing, embossing,
okay.
And shearing process.
Okay. Embossing as well as coining, and trimming as well as shearing process. Okay, so the all of you take down the first internal portion for the test. So module 4 is full module 4. Next, in module 5, so three types of shearing process. What are those? Shearing operation, cutting operation. Next, cutting operation. Next,
drawing and
bending operation and drawing operation. Bending operation and drawing operation. Then embossing and coining.
Embossing
coining and trimming as well as shearing process. Then one more topic is there, that is nothing but dies. Okay, different types of dies: progressive die, compound die as well as combination die. This much portion is there for your first internal. Understood? So in module 5, once again I will repeat, in module 5, what are the portion is there? So different types of sheet metal operation: cutting operation, bending operation and drawing operation, and embossing as well as coining operation, trimming operation, then shearing process, then different types of dies, progressive die, compound die, as well as combination die. So this different types of dies until I will explain in the next class. Okay, I will explain in the next class different types of dies, everything. Okay, so I hope all of you understood the portion till here, whatever we discussed, and remaining portion is not there for your first internal. Understood? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, Sajun. Sajun. Is not there, Sajun. Ronak.
Yes, sir.
Ronak. Can you explain any one of the operation which we discussed today's class?
Which one, sir? Which one today?
Anything. Anything is okay. Mohammed Mustafa left. Okay. I'll not down in all the members. Okay. Tell me anything. Prajwal Suresh. Prajwal Suresh.
Yes,
explain anything. Anyone operation?
Embossing.
Tell me. What is that embossing?
It is mainly used for designing or decoration.
Okay,
purpose.
Good. Okay. Just okay, enough. Prajwal Suresha. Okay, done. Okay, Jaswin. Jaswin is not there. Jaswin is not there. If it is not able to interact, you can chat in the chat box also. Jagat.
Sir.
Jagat.
Yes, sir.
Explain any one of the operation.
Sir, you can hear, sir.
You
can hear, sir. Ronak.
Okay, Ronak. Okay.
Not audible, sir.
Sir, coining process.
Now audible.
Yes, sir.
Jagat. Ronak, okay. Ronak, tell me. Coining process.
Coining process in which work piece that is like sufficiently high stress is induced.
Okay.
Where there is a plastic flow on the surface of the materials.
Okay. Okay. What is the purpose of using coining operation?
It is a closed forging processor.
Forging processor. Giving impression on the both side of the workpiece. That's the coining process. Okay.
Yes.
So next, Jagat.
Sir.
Tell me.
Coiling process.
Explain.
It is the process used to.
Used for what? Okay. You study, okay. It is available in the Google Classroom. All of you please study. Okay.
Yes.
So it is there for your first internal.
Sir.
Okay. Yes. Next, Chetan.
Yes, sir.
Can you explain any one of the process?
Bending process.
Okay. What is bending?
Bending process to metal sheets, sir. That one bending.
Okay. Then.
Next.
Cutting
process.
Cutting next. Process, bending process. Next. One more process is there.
Fixing.
Huh? Fixing. Fixing what? What, Chetan? Huh? Samrit.
Drawing process.
Yes, sir.
Explain in one of the process.
Stretch forming, where carriage holds the sheet metal and carriage and forming die blocks are moving in opposite
direction. Okay. Good. Okay, Samrit. Next, Sambram. It's not there. Nikhil Shetty. Charan. Jason. Amal Raj.
Yes, sir.
Jason, explain any one of them.
Second leave, sir.
Okay. Jason.
Thank you, sir.
Don't know.
I know, sir. Bench forming and you die. We can leave, sir.
Okay, we'll discuss in the next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.